Let's talk about DC. No excuses. I was ticked off. They wouldn't let me do my job, so I didn't take the vote.
No excuses, says Lauren Boebert, who missed the vote on the debt ceiling bill. Now, unfortunately for her, receipts show that she's lying. But before we get to her lies and show you the receipts, why don't we hear more from Lauren Boebert on why she allegedly missed the vote?
Once again, Washington's power machine shoved a multi-trillion dollar bill down our throats, refused to allow debate or amendments, disregarded everything we fought for in January to actually allow representatives to do their jobs. And instead, they served us up a crap sandwich. Call it a no-show protest, but I certainly let every one of my colleagues and the country know I was against this garbage of a bill and against bypassing the voice of each representative. Deals cut in the dark are why we are headed towards $36 trillion in debt, and I refuse to be a part of it.
Right, so it was a protest. She refused to vote on the legislation because she was so against it. I mean, it would have been better to vote against it if you're actually against it, right? But she didn't show up to vote. And it turns out that she's lying when she says it was a protest or she was taking part in a protest because video evidence would prove otherwise. Let's watch.
They just closed it.
They closed it?
Yeah.
That was Lauren Boebert rushing to the House floor so she could vote on the legislation, but she didn't make it on time.
And when she didn't make it on time, she got there and said, I protest.
What a clown. Okay. Come on, Lauren. Lauren.
So look, to be fair to Lauren Boebert.
Just don't say anything. I didn't even know she didn't vote on it. Just don't say anything. No one cares about you. No one's paying attention to what you're doing.
Well, look, everybody lives in their own bubbles, right? So probably in her conservative bubble, there were people like, hey, why didn't you vote against that bill? Are you equivocating?
Maybe. Right? Okay, decent point.
So she wanted to prove that no, she was on their side. Now you could do that without even mentioning that you missed the vote because you're a clown, right? And you could say, hey, look, no, I hated that bill, but I had something to do. Keep it vague, okay? I had something to do like run, but be late, okay? But to be fair to Boebert, like—
Look at her running.
Oh, come on, come on.
I gotta get there, I gotta get there.
Did I miss it, Oh, later, I'm gonna pretend to be principled. Most politicians are like that, right? I don't know that it's necessarily skipping the votes, but they assume that there's no tape of them anywhere. Like when Mitt Romney was running all the way back in 2012, he would say one thing to one audience and another thing to another audience, completely different, like back to back, okay? Why? Because in the old days, and I talked about this all the way back then, it was hard finding tape on candidates. They'd be like, they'd bring in a VHS and we got this from Romney in 1987, it's different than what he's saying now. And that'd be like a big gotcha, right? Now everything goes on YouTube. But they haven't caught on. And so they keep doing what they always do, which is lie. Like they lie about this, they lie about that. They lie to this audience, they lie to that audience. Hey, what do you want? What do you want? I'm a greasy politician, I'll give you whatever you want. Except, brothers and sisters, you're all on tape, right? So when you say, oh, I didn't vote out of protest, and there's your dumbass running up the stairs trying to vote in time, you're gonna get caught.
It's true. And look, the evidence is important, right? Being able to call out politicians when they lie to the public is important. But I think we've graduated into a different and more awful environment where for a large portion of the public, actually, I think most voters at this point, they just reject the evidence. And it happens on both sides. I'm just keeping it 100 with you.
It happens on all three sides.
It happens all over. It doesn't matter what kind of voter you are. If some new information arises that challenges your preconceived notions, it is like one of the most impossible things to get people to just say, oh, I now have new information and I have changed my mind. It doesn't make you a bad person when you do that. It makes you a better person when you do that.
Yeah, I'll give you quick examples. So the Republicans, they deny everything that, like elections, et cetera. So that's easy, Okay, but how about establishment Democrats? Giving everything the Republicans want, but not conceding on 10% of their demands is a giant win for Democrats. But what did Democrats win back in the debt ceiling deal? Nothing. And did the Republicans get these 8 different provisions when they didn't need to? Yes. So how's that a giant win for Democrats? But they all believe it in their alternate reality. They believe it with every ounce of their being.
And they'll keep repeating it.
And they'll say, oh, what a big win for Joe Biden.
Right.
Giving the Republicans 8 different things. What a big win. And they don't realize they sound nuts, right? Okay, now let's go to progressives, okay? Because we are fair and honest on this program, okay? So you show them a poll showing that 78% of African Americans do not want to defund the police. They're like, no, they do. What do you mean they do? There's a poll, there's no question about it. I don't believe in polls. Anyone who wants to deny reality, easiest excuse, I don't believe in polls. 78% is not around the edges.
No, they'll attack the source of the polls. They'll find any excuse to just reject the evidence.
Guys, what do you think the Republicans are doing? What do you think the establishment Democrats are doing? I don't like inconvenient facts, so I'm choosing to ignore them. So we all do it, and we're trying to do actual news where we pierce everyone's bubble and get you to see things as they actually are, not as different sides are marketing them. Right? And in this case, Boebert's such a clown that it's an easy bubble to burst. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.